when a depressive episode strikes, many people experience a complete loss of appetite, where preparing and eating a single meal can feel like an impossible task. However, other people feel a compulsive urge to eat while depressed, and may then suffer the consequences of weight gain and self-image issues once the depressive period ends. When you struggle with depression, common symptoms include fatigue and a loss of interest in doing things, even things you previously enjoyed. Thus, many people forego taking care of their nutritional health. This simple act of self-sabotage, skipping a meal here or there, can quickly become a cycle. A lack of nutrients means a lack of accessible energy, which leads to greater fatigue and greater feelings of despondency when faced with basic tasks. Being depressed can often be tied to anxiety and high levels of stress, conditions closely tied to the release of stress hormones into the bloodstream. Chronic anxiety and depression can affect the gastrointestinal system and its release of hunger hormones, like ghrelin, effectively suppressing the appetite. A sudden decrease in nutrients can weaken the immune system and make it more difficult to overcome a depressive episode. On the contrary, some people notice a sharp spike in their appetite and find it difficult to stop eating if they're feeling depressed. If you are feeling worthless or depressed, any source of pleasure, external or internal, is highly desired. Eating is one of the easiest ways to stimulate the release of dopamine into the system. Emotional eating occurs because eating food alters the chemical composition of your brain, triggering your pleasure centers. When the temporary pleasure of eating is gone, however, the other symptoms of depression return, which leads people to once again open the fridge. As it turns out, studies into the circuitry of the brain have found that different parts of the brain control appetite variation in depressed patients. Depression-related decreases in eating are associated with hypoactivation of min-insula areas of the brain, which control the body's physiological state. Essentially, the brain isn't as concerned with taking care of the body's needs, so it doesn't generate hunger, leading to a disinterest in eating food. On the other hand, depression-related increases in eating are linked to hyperactivation of the reward circuitry of the mesocorticolimbic system, which controls our sense of pleasure and enjoyment. Basically, eating will provide even more pleasure than normal when depressed, making overeating almost inevitable. While it may seem difficult to change your own brain chemistry, awareness is the first step. When you detect a change in your appetite, self-reflection and charting a course of action is critical. One of the best ways to manage your appetite while depressed is to meal plan. This is helpful for both increased and decreased appetite symptoms. For those who find themselves overeating, having set meals in individual containers helps with portion control and self-regulation. Similarly, for those with a lack of interest in cooking or low energy levels, preparing meals during good moments will make the reheating of planned meals a more tolerable option. Identifying why and how you eat in response to emotional turmoil will help you recognize negative behaviors and work to avoid them. If you know you have a weakness, being able to see it coming from a mile away will help you avoid unwanted behaviors.